St Ignatius College is a Catholic Jesuit school with three Youth Against AIDS clubs. The aim of these clubs is to spread AIDS awareness and to promote an AIDS-free generation. We are going to be having a week that is dedicated to spreading this AIDS awareness, and the theme of the week will be Ensuring Africa's Tomorrow Today. Therefore, we have compiled this video so that we can help in spreading this message, and we hope that you will enjoy it.
St. Ignatius College where we are at now. Next year we celebrate 50 years, Golden Jubilee, so the college was started in 1962. We use what we call the four C's, you know, the letter C. And those kind of encapsulate what our vision and the kind of principles we try to implement at this college. So the first C is competence, that we're trying to produce students who are professional, who are competent, intelligent, obviously who do their, you know, their studies very well, who pass well, and we're very fortunate at this school. We have excellent O-level and A-level results, usually the best in the country. But not just a narrow academic education, trying to give a wider education to our students. You know, taking in a lot of other areas, social issues, moral issues, spiritual issues, so that they can open their minds to the problems of the world, the problems that they'll be facing when they leave school. And the second C is conscience, that while the intellectual dimension is highly important to really help the student develop their minds, their imagination, their creativity, but that's not enough. You know, I often say to students, what does it help you if you've got a head like a computer, you've got lots of facts and information, but your life is a total mess. You can't sustain a relationship, you can't keep down a job, you're unreliable, you're dishonest. So to try and give them moral values, you know, to help them to see what's really good, what's bad in life, what's right, what's wrong, what's going to help me personally to really grow as a integrated, fulfilled human being, and to help others to also to grow well. And then finally, the last C is Christianity. This is a Catholic school, Christian school, and we're not ashamed of it. That's what we stand for. That's what we believe in, and that's what we want to share with our students. We're not trying to make them Catholics. No, it's not a narrow denominational kind of thing, but we believe that Jesus Christ is the full revelation of God to us, and he's the way that leads us to true life, to true happiness. And we want to give that to our students. It's something we want to share with them.
My name is Ignatius Padya, and I'm a Jesuit scholastic working at St. Ignatius College. I am the patron of the Youth Against AIDS Club here. I've been patron for the past 2 years. Youth Against AIDS Club at St. Ignatius is, we could define it as a growth group that is aimed at ending the spread of HIV and AIDS. We do this by promoting moral values amongst our youth, the students here. We refer ourselves to a support group that provides that atmosphere which enables the young ones, the youth, to share what is happening amongst themselves, issues to do with their sexuality. We give them the atmosphere, the arena, for them to talk freely about these things and probably find help from their peers. We also refer ourselves to a group that facilitates behavior change. We believe that behavior change is not something that can be dictated to someone and come out at that moment, but it's something that takes time, that needs some building through things like values, principles. We believe that the students can actually end up being responsible people in the society, people who can actually have beliefs and able to stand for what they think this is what is right for themselves. So we are promoting young people to be critical, independent thinkers who can stand for themselves out there, because there's a lot of pressure when they go out, when they leave our school. So we want them to be equipped with the necessary life skills that they can face the world out there. One might wonder, what is the role of a patron? I am the patron or teacher in charge. Well, my job is simply accompaniment. When I say accompaniment, I refer to the gospel. There is that part when Jesus was accompanying the two disciples on the road to Emmaus. What happened there is that Jesus did not tell them that he was the one who had died and risen from the dead, but he helped them to understand that he was the one. That is what I do. My job is to be present to the students. When they have their club meetings, I sit with them, I listen, I give them, I help them to reflect with my own contribution, I help them to clarify things. Maybe there could be some contentions here on issues to do with HIV and AIDS, give them some material. Basically, I'm there to give them that support that they deserve. Otherwise, everything, they do it on themselves. So I provide the club with material on HIV and AIDS. Also, an element that is important for me here is to provide that psychosocial support, counseling. We have students here. They have a lot of problems. Some of them have a lot of problems, and they need someone whom they could trust, come and discuss these issues with. And I am there for them, to support them if they have problems at home or even amongst themselves, relationships. These are issues that affect the youth in this school. I am there to give them that support, some counseling, even though we have our own counseling department.
Our club is also linked to the Jesuit Aids Project. The Jesuit Aids Project, they facilitate the YAA clubs in many schools, I think up to about 30 schools. How we are linked to them is they train some of our students as peer educators, and these, when they come back to the school, they also assist me in providing some counseling to some of the students, and also in the sessions that we have, just to make sure that whatever is happening in there is the right information, what we want them to know about HIV and AIDS. And also we have youth peer facilitators. These are also trained by Jesuit Aids Project, and they also help us with training our leaders. Like, for instance, here I have three different executives, and the chairperson, secretaries, treasurers, they go to Jesuit Aids Project camps, and they spend maybe a week or so in leadership training, life skills, so that when they come back here, they actually run these clubs professionally. And this has been very helpful for me as a patron, because I don't have to do everything, make sure that the club students are there right time and the program is there. They prepare everything on their own. All they do is they let me know of the topic before time. I do all my own research, and they run the show. They choose a facilitator for the session, and everything is done according to their plan. And I think that is quite helpful. If we were to go broader, we have the AJAN, which is African Jesuit Aids Network. This is a Jesuit initiative, which is the one that sponsors largely Jesuit Aids Project and many other Jesuit initiatives that have to do with HIV AIDS responses in Africa and Madagascar. And I must say, we are greatly indebted to them. Even for this project, our Youth Against AIDS Week, they helped us with some sponsorship, and they also give us some material in terms of books that we display on our shelves in the library. We have what we call the AIDS Corner. It's not very, very pleasing because it has a few books, but they are there, and we get these things from AJAN and many other organizations that we work with. So I'm greatly, greatly indebted and grateful to both Jesuit Aids Project and AJAN at large for their support.
This is an organization that was aimed at spreading information to the youth. So one way of doing this that they thought of was inviting young people to a week-long seminar to teach them to become peer educators. Peer educators, these people were supposed to go back to their individual schools and to be able to guide meetings for youth against AIDS, to be able to provide advice where it's needed, technical information even, which was also taught. So I attended this week-long camp back in 2002. We learned many things, how to be assertive, life skills, giving advice to people. We also learned of the very technical part of HIV. Most of that textbook information people don't ever really get to know. We heard most of the misconceptions and how they can be corrected, and basically how we can help to guide people to have good meetings and give good advice so that we can make a change in this world. Being a peer educator, especially in this boarding school setting, it's quite tricky really, because this is the formative stage of the people where they're asking many questions and they don't really accept that many answers. So in terms of things like morals, and take for example abstinence, those are very topical issues around this particular age. So putting the best advice in a good way that will be accepted and not be taken necessarily as dictating is very difficult, because once you try to start speaking, you are always at risk of being labeled the goody two shoes, if you know what I'm talking about. So it's a very, very tricky process of dealing. Of first, you have to know the people, how they react to certain situations and to certain advice. I believe I've become a much better person because, as I said before, you have to get to know people. So I believe I'm more in touch with the people around me, my school, and also I've also learned how to judge people's characters, which is a skill that you need in life. It has also taught me to be more understanding to people, to understand that situations are different, lives are different, and also by bringing me in touch with many people's problems which they bring to me, it has made me a person of greater depth, which I believe has always been one of the Ignatian ethos and principles. It has made me so much a person. I'd like to believe now that I was a very shallow person, never really understanding where someone is coming from, what they're all about. But now when you are in touch with their problems, their lives, their struggles even, you become a much better person. So being a peer educator and a facilitator has definitely improved me.
St. Ignatius AIDS Week, 7 March to 13 March 2011. We had this week with the theme Ensuring Africa's Tomorrow Today. As part of our week, we planned a number of activities which would do so that would spread the message, this message represented by our theme, to our society and to our peers in our school. We began our week by distributing ribbons to all members of the school, that is over 400 students plus the teaching and non-teaching staff. This was a gesture that was meant to show that everyone at our society would be involved in this week. After that, we had an assembly presentation during the school assembly where two of our members advertised our week and said what it was all about. On Monday again, there was the junior level mass, and the 4 months and form twos who are members of YAA did a presentation during that mass so that they could showcase their talent as well as their message to their peers in their various streams. Again, after supper on that day, the A-level students had movies which they watched, and after each movie they would then be involved in discussions that were led by our peer educators so that they could also give their opinions as well as help each other learn about the various issues affecting them today. On Tuesday, we had the O-level mass where the Form 3 and Form 4 members of Youth Against AIDS presented on various topics in the chapel, and again after supper there were movies for the junior level pupils and discussions facilitated by their respective peer educators. On Wednesday, with our sister school St. Dominic's Youth Against AIDS Club, we as St. Ignatius Youth Against AIDS visited Mavambo Trust and Mashambanzo Trust. At Mavambo, there they keep children who are less fortunate and disadvantaged in society. And our aim for going there was to show them that they are not alone in this world. We played various games with them, but unfortunately we couldn't spend much time with them. But we did leave them a few gifts that they could keep and that they could use to benefit their own lives. After that, we immediately went to Mashambanzo, where again
they are terminally ill people who are suffering from AIDS. We managed to talk to them and interact with them and know what they're all about. And again, we did show them that they're not alone. This exercise was also meant to reduce stigma amongst us as the youth and for our club members to really know what is going on in society and to really know the situation on the ground. We'll use this to inform and educate our peers. After that, we left them a few gifts, what we could, that is the gifts we'd collected from all the students of St. Ignatius College, our many thanks to them, and we went back to school. On Thursday, there was school mass for the advanced level students, and there was a presentation by the Lower Six Youth Against AIDS members. In this presentation, it was meant to again teach our peers, and after supper, there was movies for the ordinary level students. After the movies, again, our peer educators led them in a discussion, and this lively discussion was quite long. And I say there are many opinions, but at least at the end of the day, everyone is able to learn something. On Friday, the school hosted a sports event for the whole district. As such, we had many visitors from so many places, and our Youth Against AIDS Club took this as an opportunity to teach people from various places and to share their experience. As such, our peer educators set up an information desk at the grounds where anyone from any school could come, pick a pamphlet, read, ask questions and discuss and also give their opinions. And then comes the big day, Saturday the 12th of March. This was when we hosted our joint Youth Against AIDS Festival with St. Dominic's under the themes Ensuring Africa's Tomorrow Today and Young, Black and Proud. There were various schools invited to this event, schools like St. George's, Dominican Convent, Lord Malvin, to mention but a few. However, these schools are actually more than 10. Each school participated, doing something, singing a song, perhaps acting a play, giving a speech, but at the end of the day, everyone was happy and everyone learned something. And to spice it up, there were prizes for the best presentation, the third prize being a $20 prize, and the second prize being a $50 prize won by St. Ignatius, and the first prize that went to Lord Malvin was a $100 prize. We also invited various local artists, the likes of Maskiri, Terai Mugadi, a former St. Dominic student, the likes of Rocky, who shared with us and also entertained the crowd that was gathered present. It was a certainly eventful experience and a one-of-a-kind experience. Then comes Sunday, the closing day of our Youth Against AIDS Week. Our patron did the sermon during our school mass, and he talked about discipline, self-respect, self-control, all in fighting the pandemic of HIV and AIDS. The mass was attended by the whole school and was meant to summarize everything that we've been doing during the week. St. Ignatius Youth Against AIDS is not a club for itself. It is a club for society. That is why we had this week, and that is why we hope certainly that it benefited our wider community. Thank you. Children, I believe.
I think we can think of ourselves as young people in terms of the analogy of a dam. There's a way in which we can frolic along, we can be like a river, like the Zambezi, that runs along very freely. But if we are able to restrain ourselves, if we are able to put a dam and allow ourselves to be dammed, allow ourselves to be constrained and channeled, channeling ourselves and being channeled, we, by damning ourselves, become a much more powerful force that can have all kinds of good effects in the life of our countries, in our very own lives. So when I speak of damning the Zambezi, drawing the dividends of discipline, this is the idea I have in mind. That if we allow ourselves as young people with the potential that we have to be restrained, to be disciplined in our various realms of life, for instance, in our reproductive health, if we allow ourselves to be channeled and channel ourselves, we can become that kind of a force, like the Kariba Dam, that gives out all the benefits to society. So today, my message for you is simply that of a sense of being dammed, allowing the force of the river of our youthfulness to be dammed, so that we, channeling our energies in the right manner, can become forces of power, of electricity, of wealth to our nations. So this is the analogy I propose to you today. When you think of yourselves in terms of the Kariba Dam, the Zambezi River, dammed at the Kariba Gorge, that enables the benefits of discipline to be drawn for yourselves and for your society. I think this is my message for you today. This is what I would like to leave with you today, that as young, gifted, and black people, as you who are trying to ensure our tomorrow today, let us restrain ourselves. Let us allow ourselves to be restrained. Let us allow ourselves to be disciplined, and together draw the dividends of this discipline for our societies. I hope this will be something that we shall leave today's event remembering and trying to carry out. I thank you very much.
Young people have contributed a lot to the fight against HIV and AIDS. One of the very first Youth Against AIDS clubs was here at St. Ignatius. And I take pride in realizing the long life of Youth Against AIDS Club at St. Ignatius and the dedication. And we have the largest population, I gather, of youth who are putting their efforts together to fight HIV and AIDS. I haven't been here for many years, but I gather you have 3 Youth Against AIDS clubs. That's a thing to be applauded. It shows you have got really strong roots and you are determined to fight HIV and AIDS. And nobody can do it better for you young people than yourselves. We have a lot of faith in you that young people, given the right information, knowledge, and formation, they will one day realize an AIDS-free generation. So with the purity of mind, body, and soul, HIV and AIDS is no chance to not touch us. So let's try and buy the virtue or the value of chastity. We will walk along that road, chastity road, slowly, but never looking back. We keep going ahead. We will not abstain and resume, but we will assume chastity and all go. You said today, tomorrow. So from today and our tomorrow, we will walk the chastity road. This is our new thrust in the Jesuit Aids Project.
Young, and I'm gifted. Planning on the side, and I know I'm uplifted. Think so hard, you know that I'm gifted. Taking on the side. Take it on back, and you know I'm a gifted. What? You swear it was I'm gifted. Nah, I'm a young lad, now I'm gifted. You know what it is. If you're young and gifted, put your hands up. It's your boy Jesus from Melbourne. What's me? Young and gifted, young and gifted, young and gifted, young and gifted. Young and gifted, young and gifted, young and gifted, young and gifted. Young and the gifted, young and the smartest, young and the cool, and for sure you can swear it. Yeah, you know that I'm gifted. Take it to the side and you show you that we're gifted. Fight it, believe it, if you can swear it. We're the young and the gifted. Yeah, you gon' know that we're gifted. Every time we hear it, and we show you that we're gifted. You know what it is. You know what it is.
slide off. Turn you into vapors. You will serve the truth.
You endure to the end, walk through the strongest wind. And when our hope was dying, you brought us healing. And now I got something to tell my children.
Function like this with children of school going age. So to interact with them, just hearing where they are in terms of their minds and, you know, their maturity. And I was so impressed by so many of them, how down to earth they are. The message is getting out there and they feel it. So it's inspiring me to continue speaking the truth, being honest with people, but spreading a message. You know, so today we were, you know, it was Youth Against AIDS, and I think my biggest message to the youth was, don't take for granted the groups that you are part of in school, because when you leave, the roots that you have set in at school, you actually use them.
In conclusion, I think you have seen from this video that St. Ignatius College is a school that has many morals, values and principles, and with many young people who are dedicated to fighting the spread of HIV and AIDS. Therefore, we hope you have enjoyed this video and it will encourage people from other schools and other communities to try to come up with videos that showcase their works as well, so that we can all spread the message and spread the awareness of HIV and AIDS. Thank you.
In your heart, you know we're not alone with him. Precious pile and feeling inside, torn apart into pieces. Now it's off in your mind. All the hurt and deceits, what's left behind. Now you're left in the open, got nowhere to hide. But I'm here to tell you, you got not in the fear. Stay strong like a soldier, cause your army is here. Till the sun don't shine when you ain't strong. I always be the friend you can only know. Let the rain come down and wash away all that hate and regret of your yesterday. Like lighting your life, I shine all day. When you're feeling all alone, you can lean on me. No matter the type of day or night go long, got nothing as your own, like you rolling stones. When you're setting down, just take this song, put it in your heart, you know you're not alone. No matter the type of day or night go long, got nothing as your own, like you rolling stones. When you're setting down, just take this song, put it in your heart, you know you're not alone. When the world is still, there ain't no sound. When you're looking for some hope, but none is found. Feeling like you're trapped in the try to shout, trying to break free, but you always been bound. From an early age, you've been sent a stage for all the wrong reasons, and you feel your cage. And you're still amazed on how each day passes like the wind with so much pain. You got so much pain, but don't you fear, just count all your laughs and not your tears. When your windows get clouded, it all gone clear, I'll help you pull through, you know that I am here. No matter the type of day or night go long, got nothing as your own, like you rolling stones. When you're setting down, just take this song, put it in your heart, you know you're not alone. No matter the type of day or night go long, got nothing as your own, like you rolling stones. When you're setting down, just take this song, put it in your heart, you know you're not alone. Now you're flying like birds above the seas, looking at the cold world turns to green, saying to yourself, this can't be me, as you fly out of pain towards ecstasy. And the rain has stopped, the sun is shining, your frown is now gone, and you start smiling. No more limits, so let's start climbing. Your eyes are not shining, reminds me of diamonds. No matter the type of day or night go long, got nothing as your own, like you rolling stones. When you're setting down, just take this song, put it in your heart, you know you're not alone. No matter the type of day or night go long, got nothing as your own, like you rolling stones. When you're setting down, just take this song, put it in your heart, you know you're not alone. No matter the type of day or night go long, got we young. We black. And thank God. Cause we talented.